What's going on, guys? It's Dylan coming to you with a commentary today, but today I have a special guest.
Hey guys, I'm BuzzSaw, and if you don't know, my channel is AK BuzzSaw Gaming, and I'm a friend of Dylan for a long time, and I came onto his channel to do a Dual Comm, and I'm really happy to be here.
Alright, so BuzzSaw, we're going to be doing a Dual Comm based around Jersey Shore. Let the people know why you would be a good candidate to know about something for real-life Jersey Shore people.
Well, unfortunately, or actually it might be a good thing, I live on the Jersey Shore, and I don't actually live where, like, for example, the show is filmed, but I live close to the Jersey Shore, about a 20-minute drive from the Jersey Shore, so I know the talk of the town and everything about Jersey, so, yeah.
So, I'm going to start off with a series of questions just based around why, like, different things of, like, is it really like it is on the show? So, it's one of my first questions is going to be, are the people really like that on the Jersey Shore? Like, if you went to the boardwalk, would you see a lot of people like them? Or just walking around Jersey in general, would you see people like that?
Well, I live in, like, as I said, I don't live right on the shore, but I live as a 20-minute drive to the shore. But I do notice people, when you go closer down to the shore, that's when they start to get rowdy. And it's really funny. They act really funny up near the beaches and stuff, the beach areas, which is like Atlantic Highlands, Point Pleasant, Seaside Heights. That Seaside Heights is where Jersey Shore is filmed. And it gets kind of really awkward up there, but where I live, I kind of live in the non-beach part. I just live in a city and stuff, so it's really calm over where I live, but down by the shore, it gets crazy.
Okay, so you would say that's actually an accurate depiction of what the people are like near the beach?
Yeah, only near the beach. Where I live, it's really laid back, and it's just fun and chill. And
okay, so freak out. Would you say that a lot of people on the shore would prioritize, like, their body image over being, like, intelligent and stuff? Because, I mean, you see these people on the shore and you think, like, oh, they're all they do is, like, work out and obviously tan, and they're worried about their clothes more than maybe getting an education or whatever. So would you say that that's, like, the majority of the people down on the shore would prioritize those things over being, like, going to school or whatever?
Yeah, I definitely think that's an accurate statement, because, like, you could clearly see just walking the boardwalks, just people that just want to have that swagger and want to have that perfect image of just being good looking, really, and just being the person to work out and stuff. And they don't really care how good they did in school, or if they even went to school at all, or if they dropped out of high school. It doesn't really matter to them. It's all about the outer image,
appearance. All right, so this is kind of surprising to me. I thought it would that show wasn't really an accurate depiction, but here's some pretty funny or some not so serious questions. But does every person on the Jersey Shore try to get an STD by the time that they are 30? Is that a goal for every person on the Jersey Shore, or on the shore?
Pretty much. I mean, for the show, I watch it just for the fun of it, and actually where I go to school and, like, the people around me aren't, like, the crazed Jersey Shore maniacs by the beach, but it's really fun to watch them, and it's definitely, yeah, it's probably their goal. I mean, they just do so many crazy things during the seasons, and they're unpredictable. By every odd, they're unpredictable.
They want to have herpes by the time that they are 30.
Yeah.
So other than that, if you could take an axe to one person's head on the Jersey Shore, the one person that annoys you the most on the show, who would it be?
It's definitely Sammy. Is that her name? Yeah, the dumb bitch who honestly complains about everybody's boyfriend or everybody's girlfriend, and she just is the town crier of the Jersey Shore house, and she just pisses me off. I mean, I would say Snooki, but, like, really, that's what makes Jersey, okay?
I'm always going to agree with that. Other than Sammy, it would probably be Mike, because that guy just decides to start all the problems like he can. But, I mean, that's part of the show. Like, that's what makes you want to watch it, because there's so much drama. So, I don't know. Without Mike, the show wouldn't be nearly as good. So, I'd say probably Sammy, too, because she doesn't really, like, help the show be funny or help the show be stupid. She just makes it, like, nobody wants to hear anybody whining.
Yeah, but she just bitches and whines the whole time.
Yeah. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. This is like, I'm trying to keep it semi-short, and we're about the 5-minute mark now. So if you guys want to see Buzzsaw, I'll leave his channel description down in the description, obviously. But he does lots of different things. Buzzsaw, you can go into like pretty much what you do on your channel.
I do. I'm getting into Let's Plays more and more. I just finished off my Tony Hawk's Underground Let's Play. I like playing the classic Tony Hawk games. I'm not much of a skate guy, and I play Fallout New Vegas, Fallout 3, and COD like everybody else, Modern Warfare 3, and I'm just trying to get to 10th Prestige. That's why I don't have that much Modern Warfare 3 content yet, but in the future I will, probably in the next month I will. And if you're watching this on my channel, I think I'm actually going to post this on my channel. Go check out my friend Dylan's channel here. He does some really great content, and it would help him out a lot. So just hit him up with a couple of subs.
Go ahead and give your team a plug as well.
Oh, yeah. I just joined my friend's sniping team for Call of Duty, which is called Excel, and they're in my sub box if you're interested in seeing that. But thank you for having me on, Dylan. It's an honor. Yeah.
All right, guys. This has been it. I hope you guys had a good one. See you guys later.
Peace.